Hey, what's up, guys? It's me, Baaase here, and I am back with another episode of How to Find 4. And this time, I'm done with the old series, of course. I'm a gamer. But this time, I asked people, hey, boys. Hey, girls. Hey, everything in between. And y'all said, what up? And I said, what the fuck am I supposed to play now? And y'all said, only one dude actually said something, and I was king of tournament. He said, Norway, great rod, redux. And then another dude actually also said something. He just wanted me to play Norway, elemental skull. So I guess I'll have to fucking do it, man. So, early grenade. Yeah, let's get me some grenades in this hoe. So that's what I'm gonna do now. Ooh, let's get some. No. How do I submit to Danish rule, though? Can I do that? That would be pretty great. Wait, why did I do that? I'm a dumbass. What the fuck? I'm supposed to go here and get me some research feed. Goddamn, Norway is so far behind, but it makes sense. They are Norwegian after all. I'm sorry, Norwegians. I am just saying... Håkon! I am just saying this to make fun of you. I'm sorry. Sorry. Brother, we be the Sweden together, okay? Okay? Yes. You are not Håkon. I hate you. Right. Very nice. And let's actually look. Open the political sphere. Stick to Hoi4. Very nice. We're take a position Danish. State the Norwegian army. There's nothing to go Danish. I'm so sad now. I kind of want to join the Entente. And that's just because if the Entente wins, then what gets this thing? Nordschleswig. So I want that. I'm gonna do that. Yes, Norwegian lives are gonna die for Danish interest. Just like it's supposed to. Let's do that. And we're also gonna stick to Hoi4, I guess. Not to Venstre. That's funny if you understand. Danish. And Norwegian, I guess. La da da da. Hey.
Oh no, we do not have enough iron. My name is German. It's Norway.
Okay, Norway. Fair enough. That's really how you feel. That's really how you feel, bro. Here and that's fine. That should be all right. All right. Infantry division. Yeah, it's not good enough, but it'll have to do. Division. Are they all just called division? Division. Okay, fair enough. Fair enough, friend. I want... Where the fuck's my other dude up there? We're getting ready for the invasion of Sweden. When we are in downtown, we are just pulling them all in against Sweden. And then... Norway will finally get its revenge. And then, if I figure out some way I can do it, I will submit to Danish rule. By the way, Norwegians... That's just a joke. I'm just joking. Oh, am I? Okay. Why is this music so intense right now? Why are you both like, yeah, we are gonna be in Northern Norway. That's exactly where I'm excited. Hell yeah, brother. Cause I ain't fighting Russia. Look at them Russians. They scary and shit. So actually, how many troops do I have? Like 12,000? God damn, boy, that's not enough. I don't even know, way. I don't have enough. I. Oh, it's a little deer only. That makes sense, right? Look at how little people we have. No vision.
We get some more people. Like, just give some birth, Ryan. Give some birth, Ryan.
By the way, I have a mod on that gives great letters.
Gemini boy.
Alright, so we are opening the political sphere just to see what the fuck's gonna be going on, bro.
We got some power, James. Political power, political power.
King Ferdinand up in an airplane. King Ferdinand of Bulgaria today established the record of being the first monarch to go aloft in a heavier than air machine. And we went for a flight in a biplane with him the La Mine. For at the aerodrome at Kiviet. Prince Boris the Heir, apparent the Bulgarian throne, and Prince Cyril, the king's second son, also flew. King Ferdinand was highly enthusiastic over the flight and declared he would install an aerodrome in Bulgaria as a mark of his appreciation. He decorated M. the Lamain with the Order of St. Alexander. Okay. Archduke Ferdinand. Oh, he's not here yet. Okay. I guess. I don't know. Fuck that shit. Because I ain't the one. For a punk, for the fuck, I'm fetching a gun. Last monarch of old school. Okay.
Let's open the political sphere and stick it to the higher.
Or maybe events. But we could go nationalist regeneration. Oh, that could be pretty good. Because militarism. Ha 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 ha. I kind of want to go that way, but can I? I think I can, so let me just... Yes, let me do that. Take position, because I'm gangster. Norwegian political situation. Norway is benefiting from a calm political situation which is led by Hoi4. Since, you know, since one and the 25th of October 1909. Very nice. Very cool. The last election. The democracy is in a strong position in the country and ranks as a regional power, but if Christiania, yes, the brother, the Danish built city, government position is intended to be firm. It is not impossible that the situation could degenerate due to the growing tension between the Entente and the central powers. With 64%, we are not in danger. What if I didn't have that? The opposition was very active recently. I guess I'll take that since we're gonna go fascist, boys.
Only 59% now. Ah, my ruling party popularity. Ah,
okay, let me actually go. We need a silent workhorse. Oh, maybe a popular figurehead could be. Now that I think about it. Afterwards, I want the silent workhorse for a little bit more points. First, of course. That's pretty good.
Hogan 7th ability to me.
Very nice. I like him. I like it like that. Ooh, Frederick, the best. Very great. Early... A grenade! Oh, so part of the weapons! Yes, maybe I should build some. I clicked the wrong button because I'm a dumbass.
Labadadoo. We are never getting ready to beat the Swedes. To beat the Swedes, but we will try anyway, beach.
Ha! 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 Staying alive! Staying alive! Ha! 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 Ha!
Staying alive! South Africa Act. South Africa has joined Canada, Australia, and New Zealand as a more autonomous dominion of the United Kingdom.
An act of parliament unified the Cape of Good Hope, Natal, Orange River Colony, and Transvaal into the Union of Africa,
which was allotted the same quasi-independent state and set of privileges as the rest of the British Commonwealth. Hell yeah, bro. Look at that shit, man. They even got Louis Botta in here. It sounds like he's eating a lot of butter. You get it, Louis Botta? So fucking unfunny, bro. Hey, so we're gonna have an army of like 18k, right? I'm not taking another one because we don't have it. Ding. Sweden's like,
ooh, we have class conflict. Ooh, we have high immigration.
Oh, God, for real? They're... People will be fucked up in Sweden, mean. My name is Sweden. I'm a horrible place to live. And I am still today. Oh, God. I'm joking, boys. Oh, am I? Not funny. I know. Who said that? Helsing Force? San Petersburg? Hi, Denmark. You're my best friend. I love you. I kiss you. I kiss you. Now I suck you. Hey, we took a position, bro. We gonna stand with the Entente. Oh, man. Early industrialization, that could be good. State of the Norwegian army, though. Yeah, let's go for some early industrialization real quick. Just to get a little bit industrialized, right, boys? Right,
boys.
What the fuck, bro? Construction speed. Constructions option. Ooh, fortifications, bro. Wait, do they not have, like... trenches?
I want to build a trench.
Oh, that's Rise of Nations, isn't it? Japan-Korea Annexation Treaty. The Korean Empire, protectorate of Empire of Japan since the Japanese victories of the Sino-Japanese War and the Russo-Japanese War, has just signed a treaty with the Japanese government that resulted in full annexation. Though, the Russian Empire and the United States of America are complaining about this measure, no official actions have been taken against them yet. It seems that Korea, a country with a long legacy, will go out with nothing more than a whimper. You're hell yeah, Japan. You're a gangster, bro. You just went and did it. You wanted something, and you took it, bro. That's fucking gangster, man. That's insanely gangster, bro. Can I kiss you? Revolution in Portugal. Mirroring the former colony Brazil, the Republicans of Portugal have duped the monarchy, a string of blunders by the monarchy, mostly concerning the colonies and technological development, provoked a very small band of rebels to come together, which quickly earned the support of nearly the entire military. Though the issue monarchy phase, they're likely to be easily solved anytime unlikely soon. At least the anger of the public is quenched for now. Teofila Braga. I have no idea who you are, but you run an unstable republic, my friend. Sorry to say. How the fuck are your flag looking like that? That's fucking weird, boy. Okay. Let's take our popular figurehead. Figurehead. Yahoo! that's good. So we have 69. Nice. % of good old fashioned stability. Let's see. And that's just them annexing shit. Okay. Early industrialization. That's all right. Mainland focus or naval expansion. Do we even have a navy? I want some civilian factories, so let's develop Christiania. I forgot to look if we even had... Why did I click on planes, though? We don't have any planes. Let's look.
Oh, we actually do have a small kind of a... we have battleships. A decent navy. Wow. Let's give it to the Danes. Kind of want... gentlemanly. You, bro. You're looking great, Ryan. Let's do that automatic split off just to be gangsters. Fuck, bro. Officer Corp. Okay. Army defense. That's the only one we can get. Okay, but you are giving me experience, though. So that's the only thing that really matters. Oh, God, bro. Look at that army. It just grew with 50%. Did I just, like, add another one? Nah, that shit. I don't even have, like, that much manpower. Look at that shit, bro. We all be like, what up, Sweden? Think you're cool and shit? Did your little weird hats? We have a little less weird hats. Gangsters. Fuck, bro. We could make combustion engine. I mean, we could already get a truck. I think that's... weird, bro. Oh, we already have the combustion. I'm just being a dumbass again here, bro. Right, nuts. Okay. Armored car could be fun, but... could it? Yes. I want some armored cars. They will be made at some point, and you can't stop me, cause I am pretty gangster, needy baby. Libbity bitty 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 bitty. What? What I capitulate? What I? What I? No! Chatter left. Where chatter? No, it's not so near some palipadim boom. The fuck? Why are the Ottomans split up like this? I'm sorry. Army of bygone era? Sick man of Europe? Aya badibidu. And Saitan Mihemit? Develop Christiania, bro. Oh yeah, bro. We just developed that shit, bro. We just developed that shit, bro. You can't stop us, man. We're developing a shit, bro. Shit. Ristlandus. Sense of Norway. But that shit. Alright, let me actually go say... stand with the Entente. That's where we went. But no matter what, the Entente will give it back to Denmark. Oh, Mexican Revolution? The country must be governed by someone who really loves his people and his land. She has wealth and progress. I have all that. I am ignorant. Francisco Villa, what up, brother? Ooh, Madero. Ooh. Yara Telabitad. That was kind of fun. That was really fun. Like, just that little bit of music, bro.
Hell yeah, my friend. Goodbye, my lover. Bye, my friend. Francis occupied. Francis occupied first. Francis expanding. Colonial oil. So that Francis consultants. Moroccan sultans.
I should stop singing because I'm not so fun. The French government sent troops into the capital of the African state under the pretext of protecting French citizens during the rebellion in the Sultanese. France actually turned Morocco into its colonies.
This colonial intervention clearly will not go unanswered by Germany because it has a high influence in this region since the Tangier crisis.
So, okay, France, where Morocco go, huh? Where the fuck Morocco go, huh? Can you tell me, France? Dumb bitch. Where the fuck Morocco go, huh, bro? Germany low like? I don't care either, actually.
Oh no, yo. I got a crisis.
I have been the one. Move talking your mom to bed.
This dude's fucking good. Consumer goods factories. Holy shit, bro. Oh god. And output. Bro, hell yeah, man. We can't take that little motherfucker.
Hell yeah, bro. Look at that shit.
Okay, didn't do that big of a difference, but it's fine. Here. Not that much either, but a little bit. It's good. Gonna be more when we actually start and get into a war. Crisis averted. Agadir, crisis averted. The crisis is over. France has ceded some territories of French Congo to Germany in compensation for the events in Morocco. It was this one, right? Yeah. And this too. This time the powers didn't argue. Despite that, the negotiations were quite tense, and German diplomats considered the transfer region unsustainable for colonization. Colonial war was avoided. However, this means only one thing. War will inevitably happen to in the future. How would you know? You're not Spider-Man. Only Spider-Man could know. Resource gain efficiency. Yeah, that's good, because we ain't got no resources here, man. We ain't got no oil either. God damn, bro. Where the fuck my oil at? Oh yeah, I forgot. We haven't stolen them from Denmark yet.
The Danish belt. Danish belt. Controlled by the Danes. Most important country in the world.
Really? We already have like 4, so that's an army of 20k, if 4k, right? Yeah. Kind of want to put... I haven't produced any of that yet, so I'll wait.
Just a little bit. A little bit. I'll wait a bit. Just a little bit to be.
Oh, can French military advices. Hillary attack or not?
This thing, though.
Also, civilian factory construction speed? Huh. Okay. Fair enough, brother. So, let's go for nationalist regeneration.
Let's go for them.
Proto-fascism. Yes.
Get this country rolling, bro.
And if you're like,
why are you doing that?
The fuck? Why does it say... Oh, it says Chinese Eastern Railway. I actually thought that just said German Empire first. And I was like, what the fuck? This makes no sense. But yeah, it was Chinese Eastern Railway. A decent amount. Dmitry Horvat. There lives not that many people. I mean, it is just a railway. So having like 20,300. Yeah, you know, it's like 81k or something. They have a heartbeat. At least half of it.
I like how they're just like, yeah, we are just going directly through China, man. Because we have a railway. We don't want to go around. We just bully them to say, hey, we can go through and then control that shit. And China's just like, I don't care. I love it. Huh.
The government forced people to invest in railroads by saying they were going to build them without borrowing foreign debt, and with only national capital. But now they nationalized all the railroads, only compensating about 60% of first invented money across the empire. People are outraged and trying to stop the government's nationalization attempts through mass protests known as the Railway Protection Movement. I mean, that's kind of a douchebag move to do, so I get that, bro. You don't even have that many railroads. You have one there. And let's look at that. Do you have any home? Do you have them? Where your little railway is, huh? Well, we have any?
Can I maybe... Ooh, early mobilization, friend!
Ooh, that's actually good. Yeah. Why not? We're also building faster now.
Hell yeah, my brother. Hell yeah, my friend. Nationalist regeneration. Diversity measures.
Army politicization, proto-fascism. Revival old claims. Wait, on Russia? I don't want that right now. Claim lands. Not yet. Add militarism which grants recruitable population and damage to garrisons, military youth. Which training time? Hell yeah, and chauvinism. Pretty good. I might go for like... Let's go for this real quick. Just militarization since you see I kind of need some. As I'm soon running out. And 49 a month ain't enough.
Machu Picchu come out, did it.
Let me look at that shit, man. We're gonna put some support artillery in soon, so gonna be fine. Right now. We have quite their army. 24k, bro. Look at the Swedish, man. They barely have anything, man. We gonna beat the Swede. Beat the Swede to a bloody pulp. Bloody pulp, bloody pulp. Ah, ha, bloody pulp, bloody pulp. Ha, ha. Yeah. You soon done? No, not fast enough. Excavation. What does it take for us to go partial mode? More war support. And proto-fascism. Or a vanguardist? That's like this thing, right? No, what? Adolf Eriksson. Hey, bro. God damn, boy, man! We just an...
68.
I like Rilla. Okay, so... Yes, let's go for some dispersed industry, brother. This after, so we can do some fortifications.
For example, I don't want to fortify capital.
Yes, capital. Wait, we already have, like... Why do we have coastal forts? They are not even invented yet, bro. We do not even have invented the coastal forts yet. Mona Lisa has been stolen. Last night, a thief has stolen the famous Mona Lisa from the...
Hello, real.
This morning, Liz Bernard walked into a saloon cutting a portion of the museum.
Well, the Mona Lisa had been on display for 5 years,
only to find 4 iron picks on the wall. Local guards claimed the art was being photographed, which turned out to be untrue. Currently, the museum is closed for investigation.
He just walked away with it. Right?
Probably dead, bro.
Holy shit, man. Holy shit, balls.
Norwegian militarism. Hell yeah, friend. Because we already have an army of 30k. I'll scratch my eyeball. Scratch that shit.
Anyone give me decisive battles, yeah.
That means we are going up to like a million trillion fantasillion troops. I like how it's more gradual mobilization now compared to the old ways they did it, where you had to wait and then boom, one big one. So we're going to 6.5%. Hell yeah, bro. We can make like big army shit. First, I kind of want to do some, and that's like infantry. They're getting a little stronger here. We are using some more manpower, though, and that's to be expected. Are we Sinhai Revolution?
The idea of revolution is to win out. It must be through political enlightenment.
It is useless to try to impose it by force of arms.
Sun Yat-sen.
Min Shu Ming Quan Ming Sheng.
Okay, I wanted to see here. Yeah, we still need like 15k more. Oh, there. What a great little one.
Hubei, be like.
Yo, bro. We're gonna win this shit.
I doubt it.
Oh, wait, maybe. Because they have all these dumb shit, like... But is it... Oh, yeah, they really have a bad army. Payments of enmities. Oh, fuck, I keep clicking shit. Boxer Protocol. In August 1900, the 8 power suppressed the Boxer Rebellion, occupied Peking, and the following year pressured Qing government to sign this... unequal treaty. God. Really got fucked up, man. Yeah, they actually do kind of have like... They kind of do. Holy shit. Have, 50% bonus on defense right here. Or on core. Is everything core to them? Not everything, but a lot. And they are moving fast, so they might have the element of surprise and then just being able to hold it. And then while they're holding a few places where to get some military factories, slowly build their army up. That could be fucking insane, bro. Wuchang. I like how it's Wuhan it started in. This is so insane, bro.
Look at that shit. They doing it. They do what I didn't do. They do what I thought they would do, bro.
Oh, they still don't have any she. Goddamn, boy. She fig. Still need... Yeah. Of urine... Oh, shit. Did it just, like, spawn more? No, they're like... Yeah, let's... At the same time, attack the Mongolians. That makes sense. Fucking retard. Damn. That's it. Okay. It got bigger. That's because Jesus Christ is my...
The gamer!
Come on, Jing. You can lose this. I believe in you. Chinese civil war, bro. Ah, you lost 10 troops more. This doesn't look very Chinese. Usually there would be millions of casualties. The first Balkan War? Cannons thunder in the Balkans, and alliance led by Bulgaria associated with Serbia and Greece is currently confronting the Ottoman Empire in the West. A region compromising many belligerent minorities. The attackers have a clear objective. Throw the Turks out of Europe.
One day the great European war will come out of some damn foolish thing in the Balkans.
And that's true. The Lenique threat the BRICS. The Kingdom of Montenegro declared war. Sure, hell yeah, bro. Balkan war. I mean, it's fine. Get those Turks out of Europe. They don't belong here, I guess. And if any Turks are watching, sorry. Shut up. I love you. Constantini. Look at Ankara. Such a weird little place now. No one lived there. Yet. Independent Albania? Hell yeah, Albania. For the once. Russia abandons the French. The Entente split. Nationalist policy of Nikolai II further entrenched estranged Russian from French, which ultimately resulted in Russian leaving the Entente. Russia no longer guarantees the security of France, but is Russia secured by itself? Wait, are you for fucking real? And I'm gonna join the Entente? Oh god! Russia be like, nah, fuck the Entente, man. 20 years of peace? Threat of revolution. I guess it's fine since they're kind of like maybe going nationalist or some shit. Hey, wait, then I could go after Russia when we join the Entente. Thank you, Russia. Very cool. Nation avoid investment. Let's go for that. I kind of want some of these shit so I can build a little bit more. Have we filled up completely? We have. And we are building more. 45,000. Boys. That's a lot. That's a lot of homies for me. And let's just take these things here. Infantry equipment up in here. And of course, we have to train you. Oh, look at how our army just keeps growing in size, brother. Analytical engine. Thank God. Albania, did you just capitulate, you dumbass? I did not allow you to capitulate, right? Okay. No, but seriously. And are you really losing that hard? Oh, God, bro. All your shit is taken. Oh, if they take Peking now, you're fucked up. God, bro. Are you gonna, like... Are the Balkans gonna win? I kinda hope so. I don't know why. I feel like that would be best for my interests, maybe. Diplomatic isolation. Okay, they might just like run out of manpower. Yeah. They're gonna lose on attrition. I am sure about that. Look at these ones. They're like, yep. Oh wait, they're all on defensive country. Oh, maybe not. Maybe they won't lose. Chinese civil war. Okay, take Peking and the fucking. They're gonna take Peking, aren't they? God damn, Qing. Republic of China. Okay. kind of want to see China explode. Yep, Republic of China, end of Xinhai Revolution. Oh, very democratic, huh? Revolution, I suppose. Xinhai Revolution. Recovery after revolution, hyperinflation. Wow. That's army corruption. Ah, that's not the best way to start a revolution. Boxer Protocol. You still have that? God damn, bro. Big. Still, it still. Okay. South Pole reached. Hell yeah, friend. I'm gonna make a game where I play as, like, Chinese Eastern Railway. That could be fun. I will win. Invade China. Take it all. Look at how our army is growing. Strong and pretty.
I'm a pretty, pretty girl.
Okay, I don't actually care about having them veteran shit. Not great. Let's say close. Ooh. Yeah, let's take. I was like, ooh, close air support. But hey, wait. I don't even have invented any planes yet because I'm Norwegian. And it's the First World War, of course, though. So. It's like, wasn't Bulgaria the first one to use it in a war? I don't know. Ostlanit Arsenal.
Gonna go in orange.
French military advices. The Entente is looking kind of sad right now, because, yeah, it's just, like, French colonies in France. Are you honestly... France, are you honestly going commies? France is going communist. Oh, God. France, don't go communist on me. But you know what, boys? This will be it for the first episode of this great game and series we know as Hearts of Iron 4 Great Roll Redux. And I'll see y'all next time. Bye!